Yeah, challenge.
That's 1 foot.
Yep. On the push in though.
Some clock, the incomplete pass doesn't help, right? That's the worst, but that's what you want to avoid. And again, learning curve, he's got a long way to go up that learning curve.
Too slow.
Territory ahead to try and run for the first down. Bradley Pinion back at the Tampa Bay 20, and Trent Taylor on the receiving end for the Bengals will come up, wave people away. It's bounces out of bounds inside the 30. Check the exact mark before the Bengals take over on offense.
Where's this guy's hat?
Yeah.
Showcased his arms, so see how far he can throw the ball, how pretty a ball he can throw. But yeah, he's got to work on his decision making, making the right throws at the right time, especially considering the type of situation of football this year.
The way that camera angle makes it look like it says trash.
Yeah, very unfortunate.
After the 40-yard punt, Bengals from the 25. You know, Kyle Trask, he's going to have to wait his turn. In high school, he didn't start because the quarterback there who broke Kyler Murray's Texas touchdown record, who was a three-star recruit, accepted the scholarship to Florida. And then, of course, King, who was the quarterback in high school, who went on to start for the University of Miami. And then he had to wait a little bit at Florida, and he'll have to wait a little bit here for his opportunity. But right now, I think it's something we should watch in the preseason run. You kind of mentioned it, that Blaine Gabbert, we think, and Arians trust him as the backup. So who's that third quarterback? They'll keep three, right?
I can only imagine them keeping three. I don't think Bruce likes to keep more than two normally, but, yeah. You know, under current circumstances that we were on, they did an expanded roster last year, 16 more bodies on the practice squad. So it's significant. That third quarter is significant because you just don't know when something unexpected is going to happen, and especially in today's climate, with raging cases of COVID and the protocols that the NFL is requiring these guys to take. I mean, if you test positive, you're essentially out for 10 days, regardless, and then you have to have two negative tests before you can come back. So it's why it's important in preseason to identify the right depth.
Defense, number 91, 5-yard penalty, remaining second down.
We'll make it a second down three once they mark off the penalty.
Tom Brady and his trainer, the little guy there, Alex Guerrero, he's kept that man going pretty well for a long time.
Well, and everybody, you know, his teammates say TB12, they refer to him, and
yeah.
I think Blaine Gabbert was one of the ones, hey, I'm on that program.
A lot of guys, the diet, the exercise.
It was working for Brady, because I think it worked for me to some degree. Maximum effort. It's encouraging. Patrick carries. Not yet the first. The Bucs will use a timeout now. They'll have two remaining.
Jones is going to get a stop here on third down, and that's going to solidify it for him.
Influencing the voting is Rondae Barber.
Stop them.
You could just dial up and cast your own vote there. Oh, timeout there. That's the Bengals' final timeout. Don't think you wanted to use that there, but young Kyle Shermer here, better not make a big mistake. Zach Taylor in his third season.
It's so funny we talk about the, you know, insignificance of winning or losing preseason games. It really, I mean, it doesn't matter, no. But both coaches, at the end of the game, they want to win. No matter what it is, they want to find a way to win the football game.
Well, and that's the competitive nature. And you want whatever players are out there, right? They sure should experience. That matters to them.
You can never beat this third string, whatever. That's a lot of video you're taking here.
Preseason game.
Taking up a lot of memory.
Absolutely does go a long way.
How about John Harbaugh and the Baltimore Ravens? He's in 17 straight preseason games. He has won. That is amazing.
Look who talking.
Hello.
And for the first down to Kingston. To Quas Patrick. Inside the 45. He stays in bounds as the clock runs. Tackle Bay territory.
I know who the Bengals are making their play as player of the game. Patrick's had a great game here, especially in this third and fourth quarter. Yeah, you want bruising backs to just finish out games. He's shown that he can do that. Bucs do try to bring
and
pressure here, and they're just one short.
Pa-di.
You can see the puller, and then it's Stewart, 48, and it's not able to make that play. Goes to the ground,
and seven.
Blocked, and you know, he's the one that needs to make that tackle in order to stop him on third down.
Fresh set of downs for the Bengals. One timeout for the Bucs remaining in the 2-minute warning. Shermer's in trouble. Dumps it off to Chris Evans. And he's got a first down. Staying inbounds. Down to the 21 of the Bucs. Kyle Shermer and the Bengal offense with some big plays to keep the ball away from Tampa Bay's offense.
Drink a beer for the baby.
Let it run.
And now back for
the a first down for the Bengals, protecting a 2-point lead with 2 minutes to play. The Super Bowl champs preseason opener here at Raymond James.
Some personal injury firms seem to think that size equals power. I disagree.
As a we
have every resource to take on any case. But what's important to us
is what we
for you right now.
Good luck, go Gators!